This video will demonstrate how to add something that is not a PDF to your Mendeley library. A quick note on PDFs before we get into the details. Remember that Mendeley only supports PDF files. So if you have a document that is any other type of file, then you are not going to be able to add that directly to your library. You can still add citation information for any other type of source format, but you're not going to be able to view the file within Mendeley and highlight and annotate it unless it's a PDF. So there are a couple workarounds. The first approach would be to find the PDF version of something or take the file you do have and convert it to PDF. Then you can import it to your library and you will be able to view the citation information and the file. In cases where that's not possible, then you can take the other approach, which is adding the citation information manually. In that case, you won't be able to see the file, but you will still have a record of that resource that you can use to automatically generate citations for you when it goes time to create your bibliography. So first, let's talk about converting to PDF. If you have something like a Word document, the easiest method would be to go to File, then Save As, and then convert to PDF by selecting .pdf from the dropdown that appears underneath the file type. So if you're using Microsoft Word, it will save as a .docx by default, but if you click on that dropdown menu, then you'll see .pdf as an option for you. So if you save it that way, then you'll have a PDF file, and then you could go and import that into your library without an issue. Another method you can use is printing to PDF. This works really well for web pages. In this case, you go to File, Print, and then when you go to select your printer, instead of choosing a physical printer, you select the option that says Print to PDF, and that's going to create a PDF file of the page that you're looking at. So essentially, it's a snapshot of what's appearing on your screen. So let's take a look at that process now. Right now, I'm looking at an article that is on a web page. There isn't an option for me to download it anywhere. So in order to create a PDF version that I can add to my Mendeley library, I'm going to print to PDF. So I'll start by hitting Control P to bring up my print dialog. And then under destination, I want to make sure Microsoft Print to PDF is selected. I can see that that's already listed there for me since I print to PDF pretty frequently. But if that is not there when you try to do this, then click on that drop-down menu and then select Print to PDF. Then, if you hit Print, it'll take a moment and then it's going to bring up your File Explorer here where you can save the document, and then you can see under Save As Type, that's going to create a PDF for me. So I could save my document, and from there I could add that to my library by importing that new file. Alright, so now let's consider how to add a manual entry. This is the method that you're going to use for any document where you can't get a PDF file of it. So maybe it's a print book, maybe it's an ebook that just will not exist in PDF format. This is what you're going to use if you're okay with just having the citation information there for you. There are three steps. The first is to click on the plus add new button at the top left of your library, as if you were importing a PDF article. Then, instead of adding an article, you'll click on the option that says add manual entry. That's going to bring up a dialog on the right side of the screen where you can select what source type you have and enter in all of that bibliographic information that you have. Let's take a look at that process now. All right, here we are in my Mendeley library, and I'm going to show you how to add citation information manually. In this case, I will be adding citation information for a print book, the 2018 edition of The Elements of Style by E.B. White and William Strunk. So to add my citation information, I'm going to click on plus add new from the top left. Then I select add manual entry, and you'll see that a panel has popped up for me here. If I had a DOI, which stands for Digital Object Identifier, I could enter that there and it would pre-populate the form for me. In this case, since it's a print book, not a digital book, that is not an option for me. So I'll skip over that and go right to reference type. It has journal article selected for me now, but since I'm doing a print book, I will select book from the dropdown instead. Then I can enter the title. In this case, that's the elements of style. Then I can enter the authors, and note that it tells me to add authors as last name, comma, first name. So the first author is William Strunk, so I'll do Strunk, comma, William. And then I can add another author, where I'll do White, comma, EB. And then I can enter the year. In this case, it is 2018. And the number of pages for this book is 111. So I can put 1 to 111. And depending on which citation style I'm using, that information might not even be included, but it's always good to have that just in case. There isn't a volume number for this, but in this case, for edition, it is the first edition of this newly edited version. So I'm going to put a 1 there. This book does have an editor, and again, I can enter that as last name, comma, first name. So in this case, it's D. Morelli, Richard. Then city is the city of publication. And again, some citation styles ask for this information, others don't. It's always better to include it, especially if you're not sure which style you're going to use when you ultimately create a citation for it. So in this case, our city is San Luis Obispo, California. And the name of our publisher is Spectrum Inc. Publishing. Then I don't have a month and day of publication, so I'll skip that. Abstract, I don't have that handy either, so I can skip that as well. Then if I click Add Entry, you can see that I now have that at the top of my library. If I click on it, we can see the information I just typed in, and if I click on any box, it'll give me additional information that I entered. But you'll note if I double click on this, I'm not going to be able to see an associated file, since all that we're saving in this case is the citation information. So that is the basic process of adding citation information to Mendeley.
Thank you for watching. If you have questions, the Cook Library is happy to help. Visit bit.ly/tuaskalibrarian for details on how to contact a librarian through chat, email, text message, or individual appointment.